a spending level that we find in Washington today and no other time in the history of this country. The headline last week was, hey, things are looking up. The deficit is not going to be 1.8 trillion. It's only going to be 1.6 trillion. Isn't that wonderful? Can you imagine that kind of numbers being skipped around? $1.6 trillion, and yet this administration feels like it can fund everything in the world. It can fund the compass. Anybody take advantage of the compass deal? I'm telling you, I was telling somebody long ago, if you think of the government can take care of health care, then you look at the compass deal. Somebody picked up an idea that we could refuel those cars and we would put $1 billion in there, and they were able to redeem $250,000. How many would you guess cars were jumped last year? Anybody got a number? 11 million. 11 million cars were jumped last year. So we're gonna retire another 250, I mean, part of that same 11 million. So they said, oh, that plan's working so good, let's add 2 more billion. So now the 2 billion plus the 1 billion, that's 750,000 cars they're gonna take off the road. Bear in mind, 15 minutes, 11 million is available to qualify. So that still leaves a void of even 90% of the people just not gonna be satisfied. So the dealers now are picking and choosing who is gonna be able to qualify for the bunker and all the red tape. I've been noticing in some papers that they have given up on the fact that they're not gonna deal with the program, and that's good. And I just hope and pray that those people that are involved with the bunker deal would recognize that health care is not something that the federal government should be in the department and the overseer in. There was a last two Congress the other day, what they call cap and trade, which is going to kill jobs in America. In fact, the health insurance program, if it passes, is going to kill about 5 million jobs. But cap and trade might kill as many as 7.5 million. It's going to run most of our industry over to Japan or China or India, or one of those countries that doesn't have near the environmental standards that we have here. A third issue we've got is our energy bill. I mean, it's just, we've got more energy off the coast of South Carolina. We've got natural gas equal to what the reserves are in Saudi Arabia. We need to be able to capture into those reserves and produce natural gas. Natural gas is a good burning fuel. It's a good alternative to coal, even oil. And we've got a mass of it right off the coast. And we're not talking about off the beach. We're talking about 25 to 50 miles up there. So nobody can see any rigs. And it's safe. They can be piped into this coast. And you can burn it in your automobile. You can certainly burn it in your power plants. And it's just a good alternative. And we can keep those energy jobs in America rather than shipping them over to some of these foreign countries. Some 70% of the energy now is coming from offshore. And we can do something about it. We talk about developing nuclear power, and I think that's a good alternative. But nuclear power and natural gas, I think we could become energy independent and not be buying some $400 or $500 billion a year of foreign energy. We could be keeping that money at home and producing those good jobs here in America. Anyway, we we're grateful you would come out today and be part of this discussion. I know it's without you, the debate would never have changed. Because I'm telling you, they won't listen to us up in Washington. In fact, I was telling somebody the other day, you know, we're looking at a lot of things we're concerned about. We talk about the swine flu, we talk about the bird flu, or AIDS, or some other pandemic. But I said, what's happened to Washington? They got the Potomac fever. Because I think they thought they were Mr. Pelosi, and Mr. Reid, and Mr. Obama, and they've been inciting them with all the ideas of how to run this country. And they forgot to listen to the people back home, and I believe mean somehow or another, when they went home this August, I'm hoping that they, somehow or another, when they come back in September, they'll be cured from the Potomac people. So I thank y'all for being here today, and I appreciate y'all support. And thank you so very much. Yes, sir.
I actually have two questions for you. First question is, what's your take on H.R. 1207, the bill to audit the Federal Reserve?
I'm supportive. I'm a sponsor of that bill.
And the second question...
Ron Paul's bill, right?
Yes.
Yeah, I think we need transparency. You know, we need transparency on AIG. We need transparency on, you know, some of the other things.
Second question is, do you support reducing some of the legislative power that the FDA has and opening up the free market to alternative forms of medicine to where you can actually call B17 a cure for cancer and also potentially medical marijuana?
Well, I'm not so sure how broad powers you ought to be able to extend them, but there are a lot of checkpoints. You know, America has the best healthcare delivery in the world. And that's because we do have some regulations. I know a lot of the medicines that we have are being introduced in other places quicker than we do in America. And maybe that timeline might need to be examined. But I think something is working. We got to be very careful.